Hey, Dr. Osborne here, founder of Gluten Free Society, and today I want to give you a quick update on gluten in cosmetics and hygiene-based products. The question is one of the most commonly asked, is gluten safe if it's in your makeup? Is it in your shampoo? If it's in your shaving gel? If it's in your soaps, lotions, etc.? Many doctors that are out there are saying that as long as you're not ingesting it orally, meaning you're not accidentally eating the hygiene-based product or being exposed on the lips, like lipstick, for example, that there's no risk of using these types of products. However, some research shows that using grain-based products with gluten in them can elicit an immune response in people with gluten sensitivity and celiac disease. So it's important that you understand that so that you're not accidentally exposing yourself to something that could continue to create a chronic inflammatory state in your body. A few common examples are the lipstick. If a woman is using a lipstick and that lipstick contains a gluten-based ingredient and she licks her lips, she's actually ingesting that lipstick. Another common example would be using a shampoo. Maybe it's got grain-based ingredients. You're washing your hair. As the water runs down your face, some of it can get in your mouth. Now there's another exposure that it can get directly in your body. Another example would be shaving. You're using a shaving gel or a shaving lotion. You're shaving, guys shaving your face, women maybe shaving your legs, where you actually cut the skin and now those proteins have direct access to your bloodstream. Remember, gluten sensitivity, celiac disease becomes a systemic disorder where the immune system recognizes those gluten proteins as enemies, creating antibodies. And that goes systemic. It's not just isolated to the gut, although the original damage can occur in the gut. If you are struggling with celiac disease or gluten sensitivity issues, and you are exposing your intrinsic chemistry to gluten-based proteins, whether again it's through a cut or through an accidental swallowing or accidental licking of the lips, you can still have an immunological reaction against those things. So it's highly recommended that if you are following a gluten-free diet, because if you don't, it creates illness, autoimmune disease, not just celiac disease, then you really want to look for products that you can apply, whether it be a shampoo, a soap, a lotion, a detergent, etc., that you can apply and feel safe and confident that you're not going to get either accidental ingestion of gluten or get absorption through the skin. Remember, your skin is an organ. We use a number of different dermatologically applied medications and topical medications that absorb through the skin because the skin is an organ and it does absorb really, really well. So the science is relatively mixed. Some science will say that gluten proteins can get through the skin. Some science will say that it can't. I urge you to stay on the side of caution and really just look at labels. If you're looking at cosmetics and you're not sure, call the manufacturer, ask them about the ingredients, and ensure that it's a grain-free, gluten-free based product before attempting to use it. The same thing goes with shampoos and soaps. Same thing goes with detergents that you might use, cosmetics, ladies, if you're using cosmetics, again, anything that you apply on your body that can be absorbed into you, you want to make sure it's as gluten-free as possible by asking, calling the manufacturer, reading your labels very, very carefully. Remember, these types of products, it's not mandatory that they have to be labeled gluten-free because they're not designed for human ingestion, and the gluten-free food laws in the United States apply for ingestion purposes. So many companies will voluntarily offer up that information, but legally there's nothing binding them to that. So if you're a celiac or if you're gluten sensitive and you're trying to avoid that gluten exposure as much as you possibly can, read those labels, call the manufacturers before you start using their products. Now, in the notes, show notes below, I'll have a link to a couple different companies that offer great gluten-free solutions in terms of cosmetic and body care products. Hopefully this is helpful for you on your gluten-free journey. We've got lots more great information at glutenfreesociety.org where you can learn about going gluten-free. You can learn about the ins and outs, the trials and tribulations, and so much more. So this is Dr. Osborne. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.